I just finished a year and a half of all of cancer and surgeries and everything. And the amount of people who were behind me was just, it was just unbelievable. And what I've done and how I've done it, I am so grateful and so blessed and so just overwhelmed with the emotions that come with this final. You know, I feel like I did a marathon and we're done. And I'm so ready for the rest of my life. I'm just so ready for that to keep on going and do what we want to do and not have to worry about, hey, I can't go here because I've got a doctor's appointment or, you know. Sometimes it's a little nerve-wracking. Oh man, it's been 3 weeks and I haven't seen a doctor. And that's hard. It's a whole new life and it's a whole new way of thinking. And but yeah, I didn't think I'd be here doing this today. And I didn't realize how it would drastically change my life for the better. Nobody thinks that I have cancer, so I'm gonna be a better person at the end of it. Well, I can definitely say that I am a better person for this because it's taught me patience and it's taught me understanding and it's taught me to trust the people who are supporting me and standing behind me and my doctors. And I just can't say how grateful I am to have made it this far. You know, my parents and my mother-in-law and my husband. My husband is just, he is my rock.
Say something. This is on video. This is your last
chemo. I don't want a video. I want a picture because I can post it on Facebook.
You can put videos on Facebook. Say,
done!
Say, this is you. Your last chemo.
This is me. My last chemo.
I'm so happy.
I'm so happy. Anything else you want me to say?
We want to hear from you.
Okay. Get out of the way because she's going to unhook me.
Yeah, get out of the way.
But the next morning when Dr. Larson came to see us in the hospital, it was just so much of a relief because I told him, I said, this is the last time that I'm going to see you in this hospital. And that was such a good thing to see, to talk to him about. And so, you know, we talked about, you know, how to care for the incisions and what he did and how he did it. And it was just so refreshing to know that I wasn't going to have to go through this again. I am so grateful for the doctors and the nurses who took care of me in the hospital. And I can't say enough about the staff who took care of me. But leaving that hospital, if I wouldn't have been in a wheelchair because they have to wheel you out, I would have done a cartwheel. Because it was just so exciting being done. And the surgery was good. It was a little painful, but what surgery isn't? But you know, the end result is amazing, and I'm so happy with everything. You know, I look normal, I feel normal, I'm able to sleep on my stomach, and that's the big one. So, just gratitude. That's what it is. It's complete gratitude for my journey ending this way. Woo!
You cut mommy's
so
hair.
So funny.
Look at you, Jacob.
Oh, how funny.
What do you think, Jacob?
Oh, he's coming right out.
He's coming right out.
Whoa. Wow. She have less
money. You need careful?
Yeah, don't take the ear off.
Thanks. How about that? Okay, no, really. Thank you. Thank you to you, Neil. Because it took you to do this. This whole project would not be here if it wasn't for you. And if it wasn't for you being part of my family, and we love you, and I am so grateful that you took this to heart and you made this project your baby, because my story wouldn't be out there to help anybody else if it wasn't for you. And I love you. I do. And to Dr. Timber for telling us not only that I had cancer, because that's one thing I will never forget is his voice and how he did it. But in the same way, I will never forget how he said, we can fix it. And that was amazing. And his wife, Susan, is... words can't even describe what a lovely person she is and how she's helped me. And to Dr. Sudhu, who gave me chemo, and Sammy. You know, there was one time I stopped breathing during chemo. And it was just a reaction. It was so freaking scary. And she came in and she held my hand and she said I was gonna be fine. And when you feel so bad, and she stayed with me until everything was okay. And her staff, again, staff is amazing. And then I met Dr. Larson on Halloween. And that was so funny because it was Halloween and, you know, you get dressed up in costumes and all this stuff. And all we were talking about is Frankensteining me. That's all I could think about. And that was so funny because I met all the girls and they approached me with this project. And, you know, I feel like they're my friends. And they're just such good people. You know, good people with good hearts. And I am so grateful. So grateful to Buckhead Plastic Surgery, not only for being there for me emotionally, but for having the ability to make me look normal after surviving cancer. I'm so grateful.
Why are you walking around with your heart so heavy? Is it getting you down? Steady beat, beat, steady. And with the way you're feeling, thinking that it never will end, and I know you say you got your reasons, you kick it to